So you have two facets, and the body is typically heart shape, and the pedicle is small, thick, and lamina is also thick and broad lamina, and the facets on the sides of the body of the vertebrae, and there is a facet on the transverse process. The upper facet is larger and it articulates with the corresponding rib. The inferior facet is smaller, it articulates with the rib, succeeding rib, and the transverse process articulates with the tubercle of the corresponding rib. Okay, so now coming to the atypical vertebra, this is the first vertebra. So you have a large facet on the side. The difference is in the body, the transverse diameter is more, double than the anteroposterior diameter, and the vertebral foramen is triangular in shape. Vertebral foramen is triangular in shape and it is large. The upper costal facet will be circular, it is slightly circular, and the lower facet is small and semicircular. This posterior lateral part of the body, it is raised. This part is raised, it's not there here. Now here you can see the lateral part of the body is raised. This is known as ankle process. The raised part, here you can see this raised parts are ossified. These are ligaments which are ossified in the vertebra. This is on the side of the vertebra. Now this part is raised a little bit, and this is called ankle process. Now in the first vertebrae, we were talking of first vertebrae, the spines in a typical vertebrae are directed downwards, they are obliquely downwards. Now in typical vertebrae, the spines are directed downwards. You can see they are directed downwards. In the first vertebra, it is more horizontal, like a cervical vertebra. It is more horizontal, but there is no foramen transversarium as in the cervical vertebra. So this is the difference in the first vertebra. Body is transversely, it is double than the AP diameter. The vertebral foramen is large and triangular, and the spine is horizontally placed. Now the ninth vertebra, the lower costal facet will be absent. So these are similar faces. This is the large similar vertebrae of 9, 10th, 11th and 12th. You have the lower facet which may be very small or absent. Here there is no lower facet. So this will articulate with 9th. This will articulate with the head of 10th rib. Okay. In the 10th also, there is single facet. Lower facet is absent. The facet on the transverse process also absent in 9th and 10th. And it is similar in the 11th also. But in 11th, the spine is square shape, triangular. The spine is triangular and with a horizontal lower border. The lower border will be horizontal, and the transverse process is small without a facet. And in the 12th, the upper circular facet lie below the upper border, and extend on the lateral aspect of the pedicles. The body is large and it resembles the lumbar vertebrae. The inferior articular facet is convex. You can see convexity. This is the convex and twisted laterally. So this is more of 12th vertebra. As I am having only one large vertebra, I am showing 9, 10th, 11th, 12th vertebra in the same. And the superior facet, we are having the three tubercles which are similar in lumbar vertebrae. So these three tubercles, they correspond to mammillary process of lumbar vertebrae, and the lateral most is corresponding to the transverse, and the inferior corresponds to the accessory process of a lumbar vertebrae. So more similarities of the lumbar vertebrae. The rest of it is same as in the typical vertebra.